Here's the deck we're playing today. It's Jeskai Control. It's running many counter spells, you know, your typical control list. It's running three Crackling Drakes in the main and four Teferis as our win conditions. It's got a couple expansion explosions. It has a Cleansing Nova for some cleanup for some Carnage Tyrants and other decks. It's running a couple of Revitalize just against those really fast, aggressive decks. We get to draw a card, gain some life. It's running one Search for Oscanta. Search for Oscanta hasn't seen a lot of play recently. When it comes down, it gives you some card advantage. But other than that, I just wanted to be able to play one in the 75. In the sideboard, we have some more threats in the form of two Niv-Mizzets, one Ralzeric, and one Lyra. We have some Disdainful Strokes, Negate, some Lava Coils, a couple Seal Aways. Lava Coil is really good against the Phoenixes, either Arclight or Rekindling. Both get exiled upon dying with Lava Coil. We have a Shiv and Fire for a couple of those low to the ground decks that you just need to ping some guys away. Seal Away is not mainboard because right now there's a lot of the green black in the metagame. All the Vivians take care of enchantments along with also the Veraska. So I wanted to go ahead and test this deck. We have a couple Justice Strikes in the main. Those might have to end up being Lava Coils depending on where the metagame goes. If there's a lot more Drakes, if there's a lot more Phoenixes, I could see running the Lava Coils over that just because it hits all the Drakes, hits all the Exiles, all the other threats as well. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the matches. Hello everyone and welcome. Today we are streaming our first Magic the Gathering video. My name is Jordan and this is Crocodile MTG. Today we are playing Standard Jeskai Control. We are on the play. This hand doesn't have a lot of action in it. I am going to keep it though. Just hoping to draw into something. We do have a turn 4 Drake. Again, without any spells, it doesn't do much. But we'll see where we go from here. I'm going to go ahead and lead with this mountain. Just hide any information I can in case I'm against another aggressive deck. Alright, turn 1 Lanimore Elves. We'll go ahead and play the Sacred Foundry tap. That's not great for us. Hopefully, being that they played Lanimore Elves, they're a little slower. Yeah, it looks like maybe no turn 2 play for them, which is good for us. We are in a friendly league right now. Alright. Alright, this is not looking great for us. Definitely should have mulliganed. Alright, looks like they are going to attacks, which is good for us. Might mean no explore creature just yet. I was really hoping that we'd draw a Deafening Clarion here. Does not look like that. I'm going to go ahead and lead with a Crackling Drake. It's not much, but I might be able to get in the way of some of these guys. Deafening Clarion would be fantastic off the top here. And they didn't even attack. That's surprising to me. And it looks like they are short on mana here. I think we're just going to run out this Teferi. I need a white mana. And we're just going to plus. Hopefully we can counter. There's the Deafening Clarion. Hopefully we can counter an explore creature next turn. Tap these. It'd be great if he just runs out an explore creature. That's a Wild Growth Rocker. I'm not going to do anything with that because we have the Deafening Clarion. I'm I'm assuming he's attacking Teferi here. I will block. Teferi takes two down the three. I think we're in a great spot right here. Because next turn, I'm just going to... Might as well draw with Teferi. Play Glacial Fortress, white, red. Choose both. We'll swing in for one. And again, they're only on two lands here, which is very difficult for them. End of turn, we'll play as Chemister Insight if they don't do anything. Yeah, and they just concede. All right, so I only saw green here. I don't know whether to assume they have black cards in their library or not. I'm going to bring in these seal aways. Maybe I don't. Excellent. Instant sorceries, target creature. I think I want to bring in these lava coils because if they are running black, they might have find and finality. And take out these revitalize. I think I'm going to keep these because of their explore creatures. I know they get a little bit more value if they're running Vraskas. Or Vivian. I'm just hoping to counter their other things. I think I'm going to take out a Chemister's Insight here. Is this a Lyra matchup? Probably not, because assuming they're on black, they'll have a Chupacabra. Maybe I want a second negate. Maybe it's one sinister. I'll only run one of the seal aways. I don't know if they're running Vraskas or not. If they are, then seal away is not going to be as great. We're on the draw. I'm going to keep this hand. We have removal for their things. Alright, they are running green-black. Just put this in tapped. Deafening Clarion was definitely a good draw there. If they don't have too much gas in the beginning, then we might be able to clean up some stuff. I'm just going to play one of these cliff tops. I'm going to use my life total as a resource here. I'm going to take some damage. See what they play here. A Jade Light. I'm going to let that resolve. Midnight Reaper. Gotcha. So he plays Vraska next turn. He doesn't have it, unless he's sacrificing a land. I don't think he's going to tick up. I'm going to go ahead and run out this Clarion now. That way, if he plays his Midnight Reaper... Okay, he's playing another Jade Light. Alright, so we got two lands off of here. So his hand right now is Midnight Reaper. Alright, played the Woodland Cemetery, played an elf. I could kill both of these right now. I do have the negate. I'm gonna play this retreat in case we need the justice strike something. I'm gonna leave the negate up in case he just plays land Veraska. I think getting Veraska out of here would be pretty decent for us. Yeah, and that 6 mana Carnage Tyrant. Alright. Yeah, that's alright, because next turn we're just gonna go land Cleansing Nova. And I hope they don't have a good follow up. This was that one they revealed. I'm just going to take the damage here since I'm cleansing Nova next turn. And I'll play out this cliff top. The lacking of blue mana does kind of suck. But we'll see here. Alright, Midnight Reaper, maybe another follow-up. What did he play? Find on Carnage Tyrant and Jade Light Ranger. Yeah, I didn't have mana up. So that's not great. No. I am gonna Lava Coil this here when it dies at exile, so they do not get to draw a card. I am hoping to run or hit another Cleansing Nova off the top. This Carnage Tyrant may be a problem for us. That is not right. We're definitely flooding out on red-white, which is rough for our deck. Not having that second blue source is not good. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. They might just play a land and slam a Veraska, which isn't good for us. Jade Light Ranger. Alright, Doom Whisperer on the top. Alright, so they left Doom Whisperer there. Yeah. So, I think I need to save this Justice Strike for the Doom Whisper. We have to draw something here. That's not something. But that does give us another turn, because we can Sinister Sabotage the Doom Whisper, and then we can Justice Strike this Jade Light Ranger. We'd be at 2, and I don't see a way out of that, but we'd have to rip a Cleansing Nova off the top, I think. So, let's go ahead and see here. We're at 2. They're going to run out this Doom Whisper. We're going to Sinister Sabotage it. We'll go ahead and Surveil. That's not what we want. Man, we're just flooding out this game. Alright, we have just enough. If we hit Cleansing Nova off this, we're okay. And just more lands. Concede. Alright. Do we change anything? I don't think the enchantments really do as much as I want them to. I'm hesitant to bring in the Lyra and Nimizzets because of Chupacabra. Alright, what takes care of Carnage Tyrant? Just the Cleansing Novas? So are we looking to race here is kind of the question. And is Disdainful Stroke just better than Negate? I guess Negate counters Find. No, we can't counter Carnage Tyrant, and I'm not running the M19 land that gets rid of Hexproof. Maybe it is right. I wonder if they're running Brontodon. They do tap out a lot, so Syncopate's good. I guess we'll just run it back. This is my first time playing the deck. I had a few practice matches, but for the most part, we have a Deafening Clarion. We have all our mana sources and a Clarion. I'm going to keep this. I'm going to leave with a Steam Vent tapped. Play Clifftop Retreat next turn in case he runs out something we're going to try and kill. Or do we just kill this Llanowar Elves, struggle him on mana? Bolt the bird. What are his turn two plays? Brontodon, Jade Light. Maybe it's just better we deny him mana. We'll see if that pays off on us, or if that Justice Strike was incorrect to play. And there's a Branch Walker revealing a Woodland Cemetery. The gate off the top's not bad. I think I'm just going to play Sacred Foundry tapped. Jade Light. Midnight Reaper. Alright, so he left those on top. Question is, what am I doing next turn? Am I just running out this? I think it's more valuable to keep Negate up for the moment. Did leave that. So here's his graveyard. That's unfortunate. I am going to have to negate this here. I do not want him. He's going to play out this Midnight Reaper. The only good thing about this is now I don't have negate anymore. I'm gonna play this island. Go ahead and just. He loses three, but then it looks like we have mana up. This isn't a great position for us. Maybe I should have ran out that Clarion sooner. Yep, you can take that Chemister Insight. Jade Light. Swamp Elf. I'm assuming he puts his elf in the grave. So that was decent for us. It's not great. But we can at least counter something if it comes down. So these are gone, this is gone, this is gone. He put this in his grave. I think he just played the land. Play swamp. All right, so dismiss that. All right, this can come in and attack. If he goes Carnage Tyrant right here, that's not good for us. All right, he goes Vivian. We're going to go ahead and counter that. We'll, Do I want to? Probably better just to put this in the grave and draw. We're looking for something else, so. All right, there's a land of more elves. All right, that's a Crackling Drake. That's not bad for us here at all. Ah, I shouldn't have played that. All right, that was a little bit of a misstep from me. I should have kept it in my hand. All right, so he gets rid of that. It's unfortunate. Fine, getting Midnight Reaper and Jade Light back. Alright, we're in a bit of a pickle here. Alright, I have two blue sources in my hand. I have one blue source in my hand, and that is very unfortunate. We're not dead next turn, but we're not in a good spot by any means. Yield till next end step. Yep. Going down the one. We've been in worse spots before. Does he have something that pings us for one? No. So we have to hit Cleansing Nova or Deafening. Alright, we hit Cleansing Nova. And we have a Drake to follow up, which is not bad. Right? Yeah, we can do both. White. Destroy all creatures. Yield that. Blue. Double red. Yield through this turn, because we already played a land. Alright, we have another Drake on top. Alright, he's got Jade Light. What's he revealing here? Carnage Tyrant, that's not good for us. So he has a forest in hand. Yep. You have Carnage Tyrant. He has this forest in hand that he didn't play out. Oh, that is so great for us. Okay, so we're going to go. That was like the perfect draw we could have had. So we're going to do both. Swing in. Do we beat him? Does he have a removal spell? So blue, red. He's got to find a removal spell for both these drakes, because both these drakes are lethal next turn. I have too much mana. I'm not gonna play anything out here. Yes! Glacial Fortress. We have a okay curve if we draw land. I'm gonna be risky. I'm gonna keep this hand. Opponent is debating here. Good luck. Have fun. That looks weird. Good luck. Have fun. All right, we're going to lead on Glacial Fortress and pray to the magic top deck gods that we draw a land in one of the next two turns. There is the land. I am going to lead on this mountain in case he is blue-black and he tries to make us discard, and then we can copy his discard spell. Oh, Mr. Opponent. All right. Seeker, Squire. So, Seeker, Squire is ran in a couple different decks. Maybe this will tell us more. Fungal Infection. And he put that in the grave. All right. So we will go ahead and play this steam vents tapped, I think. Because if he taps out for something, we have Syncopate. It's going to suck if it's a one drop, like a discard spell. But if it is a discard spell, then I'm going to expansion it anyhow. So, we'll see what we get here. We do have a game, since we drew that steam vent. I do tend to keep risky hands like that if I have hopes that my 24 land deck will get me a land. We're going to go ahead and counter this. We don't want them drawing cards if we board wipe. We'll just take two for a little while. That Sulfur Falls was great. Now we have Chemister's Insight on online. And we might be able to just jam down this Teferi next turn. Which would be very good. Alright, he has four mana for something. Dread Knight. Yep, can't do anything about that. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and Chemister's Insight. It might be worth it here just to Cleansing Nova, play out this Glacial Fortress. Destroy all creatures. And then next turn, hopefully I can run out the Teferi. If he has a discard spell or something like that. This is looking like mono black. So if I run this out, this becomes a 3, attacks it for 2. He might also just have a Vraska's Contempt. I could also expansion this for 2 and draw 2. And also Clarion it. Maybe it's just a matter of going on a whim. Because if he has the Contempt, this play is not going to matter much anyhow. But if he swings, hits this the 2, and we Clarion next turn with whatever he plays next. I guess the one card I'm a little worried about is the Saga. If he makes us sack this, that'd be a little tough. If he plays Vraska's Contempt, though, I can expansion it and get the Knight. Which I don't think expansion would be worth it here. I think it's better just to explode another turn. Alright, so we're going to untap there. Fortunately, we did not get anything to kill this knight. Yep, and he has the Contempt. That's alright. Yeah, and it does look like he just is mono black here. Alright, now we draw the removal spell. What's the worst he can play? Worst thing he could play is another Dreadshade and a land, because then he could Dreadshade and boost it for 5, which makes it very hard to kill. I think I'm just going to run out one of these Clarions here. I know it seems a little pointless, but I have the Sabotage in case he plays anything ridiculous. And then I'll expansion next turn when I play out this other land. Alright, he has a lot of mana. Alright, so now I'm just gonna... I will play the expansion into this turn if he doesn't have anything. He probably just has a couple removal spells in hand. Alright, this is his graveyard, in case anyone's watching. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and expansion him for a lot. I'll draw the cards. Red, 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 blue, blue. All these can be white. I don't care. For 4. Alright. So now we have many, many, many lands. And not really much to do with them. No. Do we still have that Chemist's Insight? We do. So that might be worth playing. I should have played that a few turns ago. I apologize. I think there was an opening to play it. I'll have to go back and rewatch this. So, what are we worried about here? That doesn't do much for us. He does lose life and draw a card, so it cycles. But... we're going to go ahead and Chemist's Insight, discarding this mountain. Let me just draw a couple more lands. Untap that. It's just to strike this. He gets to draw a land, which is fine. Alright, and our chances of losing the rest of this, I'm pretty sure, is very slim. We're at a healthy 14 life. He has 4 cards in hand. We have a full grip. There's nothing that great in his graveyard. He might be playing Find, which he can get stuff back, but we have both Sinister Sabotage, a couple more Clarions, as well as an Essence Scatter. So, we'll see here. He's not adding a bunch of mana, which is surprising to me. There he goes. I was going to say, if he's worried about like a syncopate, alright, I'm just going to Essence Scatter this. It might seem a little pointless, but I just don't want him drawing more cards. Alright, he has a follow up. Alright, and we're going to go ahead and get rid of that as well. Alright, what's on top? I'll keep this just in case he has another Doom Whisperer. This tapped. Even if a Doom Whisperer comes down, it's not great for us. Alright, he doesn't have anything at the moment. We don't really have anything at the moment. Alright, that's fine. Alright, what's on top? Plague Mare. Alright. It can't be blocked by white creatures, but it can still be targeted by white spells. Alright, there's an insight, which is good. I'm gonna keep these cliff tops in my hand in case I need to discard them, which I probably will, to Chemist's Insight. And again, we'll probably be drawing more lands. I don't know. I'm going to keep them. If I draw more lands, I'll play one next turn, but... Alright, go ahead and attack in. If he plays Plaguemare here, I'll probably just, Alright, he's not playing anything. Oh, he did put that Plaguemare in the grave. That's my bad. Alright. So, we're gonna draw two here. Alright, that was good. I'm gonna draw some more. Because I'm greedy. Alright, nah, our chances of losing here are very slim. Play this. Nah, I keep forgetting to tap white. Let's see. Draw a card. I thought I already played a land this turn. No, I didn't. Let's see. What to play. He has a lot of lands here. We do not have very much for syncope. I'm gonna say no to this. I'm gonna play out this Drake. We'll draw a card. Alright, now we have Negate. I'm gonna move to my untap step. I wanna play out this Search, but I do not wanna give him a window to get rid of our Teferi. I know it doesn't seem. Yeah, so he has that. Do I care about that? I do a little bit, but I feel like he'll have more. I think I care more about this Teferi. Alright, we're gonna untap this Glacial Fortress and Steam Vent. And we'll just go to clean up. I'll discard a land. I kind of wanted to discard that Syncopate just because he has many, many manas, but... Alright, this is a Doom Whisperer, this is good. What is this? He's tapping 13 mana. It's not Emrakul. Emrakul rotated a long, long time ago. Oof. Okay, we have the Negate for that, though. That was almost pretty bad for us. Hopefully he doesn't have another. Alright, it doesn't look like he does. So he's probably going to attack Teferi down to 3 here. We're just going to Deafening Clarion this next turn. Alright, and now we have Sabotage. Alright, I think we're in a good spot here. Yeah, we're just going to Clarion here. Play out Search. I guess play this land just in case we need to syncopate something. We might end up being able to. Sure. Or maybe he just doesn't tap his Cabals, which I think is silly if he doesn't. Because they produce 8 mana for 3. We'll let that resolve, because we have Justice Strike, so there's nothing he can do with that we care about. Then we have Sabotage in case he decides to do anything funny. Alright, we're going to get rid of that here. Alright, we probably will be able to flip our Azcanta here. The question is, does he... He just concede here, I guess. It's not going to matter what you do here, buddy. Because it's plus one, plus one. Alright. Do I want the top card in my graveyard? Once we get through this phase here. Yeah, we'll put that in and we'll flip. And an island. Alright, we're gonna go Teferi. And another island. I could have activated Azcanta there and then untapped it, which probably would have been smart, but I only have 20 cards left in my graveyard. We'll see if we grab another, yeah, Sinister Sabotage. There's our Crackling Drake, which kind of sucks. We do have two more Teferis in our deck. Maybe three. Put in Grave. So once we get the ultimate this, we don't have a chance of milling out, which is pretty nice. There's one of our other Teferis. Expansion Explosion. Yeah, we're gonna just make this not a fun game for our opponent. We have one win con left in our deck. Sure. That's unfortunate for our opponent here. Actually, how much can I do here? So let's call those 4. 2, 4, 7, 10, 13. Not enough. Definitely surprisingly close to being enough. We're going to go ahead and take a look. The only reason I didn't grab our insights here was, again, because we have a ridiculous amount of cards. Sorry, we don't have a lot of cards left. Ooh, I almost forgot to activate Teferi. Talking and playing is a difficult strategy. I'm gonna get rid of this Syncopate here. Untap some lands. We do have only 13 minutes left, but we are definitely going to win this game. I'm going to take this instant scatter, but I really don't think we need it. Alright, there's a Crackling Drake. That's definitely what we needed. Alright, and I think we're okay from here. Play out this land. Oof. I can't even expansion here because it just kills us. So, I'll discard here and discard a Clarion. I'm going to pick up my speed of play a little bit. I mean, we just win next turn, so I'm not going to... I'm not gonna worry too much about it. Alright, there's another Crackling Drake. I'm gonna get an emblem. I'm gonna go ahead and just attack. We have counter magic for days, so ionize. And there we go. Hopefully we can earn our... Sorry, tongue-tied there. Hopefully we can win our next match. What do we want here? Played a lot of low to the ground threats. He is playing mono black, not green black. So he's gonna have planeswalker removal. He didn't see too many creatures, so I don't think he's gonna have a lot of creature removal. He might even take it out some chupacabras. He saw crackling drakes. Maybe it's worth bringing in Niv here, because he also doesn't have Vivian or the Vivian or either Vraska. Revitalize can probably come out. They're not super aggressive. Seal Away can definitely come in here because, again, they don't have any of the Planeswalker package that Green Black has. It's tempting to bring in Ral here. If I bring in Ral, I'd be doing 3 Teferis, 1 Ral. And I still have to cut 3 here. I think I'm going to cut the Syncopates simply because they have a lot of mana. So I'm bringing in these for creatures. I'm bringing in these for threats. Maybe I cut a Teferi, because Teferi is not impactful on a board full of 2 drops. We saw removal spells. Tempted. I'll bring in one negate. Take out one sinister. Maybe I'll just leave the one negate in. We'll go ahead and run like this. We don't want to give a game, especially with our time limit, but if they outrun us here, we'll probably just concede early and go to a game 3. We'll definitely see what our draws are like first, though. Alright, this is a keepable hand, I think. We have Ionize on turn 3, Justice Strike on turn 2. We'll lead with a foundry. We'll keep this. And we are on the draw, so this is a good hand for us. They could have discard spells. Interesting. It's fine. So I think we're gonna have a turn 4 Drake here. Oh no, we need another blue source. Alright, we're gonna play the retreat just so we can have Ionize up. If we draw a blue source here, that'll be good for us. We'll let that resolve. I'm just gonna go ahead and kill it. I think the only thing I'm worried about coming down that I really want to kill with Justice Strike is a Doom Whisperer, I suppose. But yeah, we have Sabotage, which can't be played. Hopefully we don't get flooded out with red-white lands. I might have to rethink my mana base here. Alright, so they're drawing cards, which is good for us. Alright, Squire's fine. Knight of Malice. Alright, they put that in the grave. No blue source again. Play this retreat. Yeah, that's a little bit of a rough one here. We had the early crackling drake, but no way to deploy it here. It might seem silly, but I'm just gonna seal away this. We have both Justice Drake and I still. I really don't see a point in taking damage right now. It's early. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and, because this does have hexproof from white. Alright, and another Clifftop Retreat. Might as well play it out. I don't know if this is gonna. I don't know. They skipped their turn too. So, I don't know if that was on purpose or by accident. Either way, we get the kinda draw a card and be on the play, so to speak, because of that. Yeah, and this is exactly why I took out
Syncopate.
What is this? 4/5 Menace. Create 8 zombies. Huh. 1, 2, 3. Make 5, 6, 7. Alright. I'll let this resolve. Mainly because I don't have a choice. Hopefully I draw a blue source here, thank you. I'm gonna play this untapped and play out this.
Crackling Drake.
That's a 2/4. It's not the best Crackling Drake, but something's better than nothing. Alright, they're gonna draw here. I think they need to be careful here, because this Drake gets big pretty fast, and if they play something out here and I just counter it, not counter it, but interesting. I'll let them go ahead and take something from my hand. Again, like I said, the Drake gets pretty large here, so I don't have any counter magic up, so they might just have a Vraska's Contempt, and I might just lose my Drake here. But we'll see. If they don't take Insight, that's actually decent for us. Okay. I am curious what they have, though. They have 5 cards in hand. I'm very surprised they didn't use Cabal.
Or maybe they did.
Yeah, it looks like they use Cabal. So 6 mana. Possibly 7/8. Yep. Alright, so they took care of our Drake here. Yep. They killed our knight. Or they have a knight. We can't target the knight. Lyra was a pretty great draw. They have 3 cards in hand. They're going to make us discard. I think I'm going to discard this Chemister. Doom Whisperer is a 5 mana 6/6. Yeah, I'm going to discard this Insight here. So they can attack here still, because if they have a Vraska's Contempt, ugh, that's rough. And gain 5 life here, which seems a little bit appealing. Or actually, what I can do here, in response to the trigger, I can kill that. They have to sacrifice one of these. Thank you. sacrifice my Lyra. It's not great, but it's not terrible. I think. I don't know what their follow-up is. Alright, it looks like they're just gonna draw a bunch of cards. Possibly play something. They're gonna get something back, which isn't great. Possibly even our Lyra. We're doing okay on time right now. They're gonna attack for 4, put us down to 10. Do I keep the counter magic up, or do I draw? 1, 2, 3. We have to draw perfectly, like, land Teferi. Do we have a Teferi? No. So they can get Crackling Drake or Lyra. It's gonna suck, but I think I'd rather have this counter magic up, and then hopefully, yep, they take our Lyra. Definitely not in a great spot here. Alright, we take 4. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and play Chemister. Ugh, 2 lands was not good here. 3 lands. Alright. Match 4. 8 minutes. Match 3. Sorry. 8 minutes. Alright. We didn't see any of this. They have bigger drops. I'm going to bring in the Disdainful Strokes. Maybe I keep a negate, take out the seals. I mean, seals seem fine. Maybe it's... Is this an Azcanta matchup? I mean, Azcanta's good no matter what. I think I want all my mana counter magic to be able to counter something. Essence Scatter is fine. I think I'm going to take out 1 Insight. We'll run this. Hopefully they don't get a Niv-Mizzet from us. I'm going to keep this hand. No possible plays. Yield. Play out the Steam Vent for starters. Yeah, they just had gas that whole time. Steam Vent, no. Alright, they duressed us. Teferi or Deafening Clarion. And hopefully we draw something decent. Goes to Fairy, which is fine. Alright, I'm not gonna play that. There's no reason to. Some people like faking things. It is what it is. Yep, another duress. Possibly taking Insight. Possibly taking Deafening Clarion. Alright, so he's just tearing us apart. But we're going to get some cards off this Insight. It's fine. Alright, he's going to swing in for 2. Maybe he's just missing a 4th land. We can get this Lyra down maybe without a lot of repercussions. Nope, there's the land. Sure. Alright, so what's the play here? Probably just Lyra, I'm assuming. If slash when he kills it. Yep, Chupacabra. I'm fine with Chupacabra killing it more than I am. Alright, I'm gonna expansion Reaper next turn. Let him draw a card. Oh, I'm gonna draw two. Let him draw one. Alright, so I'm gonna draw red, red, and blue. Done. Yep, we got some sabotages. Not gonna help us on this board. Hopefully we find a Clarion. That'd be decent for us right now. And hopefully he doesn't have just gas. Alright, that's something. And we don't have anything. Play Sulfur Fowls. Go down the one this turn. Sabotage. Find something. It's not something that will help us. Oh, I also have this Clarion I can draw too. Not Clarion, Chemist's Insight. Yep. Could I have a Chemist's Insight the last turn? No, because I tapped out for Explosion. Alright, we're at one. We need to find Cleansing Nova, I think. Alright, that's unfortunate. Even if we play Teferi here, plus I could fake Settle, I guess. If he's worried about Settle. If he's worried about Settle and the seal way gets him, this is good for us. But not a lot of lists are running Settle at the moment. So I'm going to represent Settle. So if I tap out here, that's fine. My only win here is the fake Settle. Yep. Yep. Alright, I'm gonna pull an LSV pump fake. Game opponent. Let him go ahead and first strike us. Promote the channel a little. And boom. good games. Alright. We are heavy 4 drops this game. Or we can mulligan. We're going to keep this. I don't see as much mono red or the white deck running around at the moment. Last couple games have been green-black. And mono-black. And even when I was testing before this, I did not see a lot of mono-red. Alright, maybe Selesnya tokens. Alright, we found the third land, which is good. Alright, so we're playing against green-white tokens. I do not know how this matchup is. Clarion's probably great in this matchup, but it's just a matter of countering his, like, Brontodons and things. Loxodons, not Brontodons. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and counter that. That is not necessarily one we want to be fighting against. We're gonna look for another land here. We're gonna see if we can be aggressive here. I know he has. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get that aggression in. Alright, here's the fourth Crackling Drake. Third Crackling Drake, my bad. Now our deck only runs 3 main board, none side. Alright, there is an Amira. He might just run a Loxodon out here. Nope. Okay. So next turn, if I draw a white source, I may just Clarion here. Alright, and Loxodon. Oh, okay, he's Convoking. That is more than fine. So I will just run another Drake out here. See what we draw first. Alright. We'll run this island out and keep this clock going. I'm hoping he just runs a bunch of stuff out. We draw a white source and we can just Clarion away the board. Yeah, we'll see what he attacks with here. I doubt he's attacking with the Amira. I would be very surprised if he is. Alright, he's probably flipping the landing here. Smart move. Alright, I'll go ahead and block a lifelinker. Vivian negative? Yep. Not negative, but minus. Okay. So, what do we do here? Gonna be able to rebuild with that Vivian. I kind of just want to run out the Drake again. I guess we don't need to tap that cliff top. Our Drake is our last threat. It's the only bad part. Other than this Drake, the only other thing we have is 4 fairies, which is good, but it's not quick. Alright, they have a Tristani. So, they might just run out the Tristani here. If I were them, I would run out the Tristani here. Yeah. Alright, nothing they produce is relevant. I mean, don't get me wrong, this is a lot of pressure. It's not like it's not. But next turn, hopefully I get to just Clarion away their board and minus the Tristani and start attacking. Hopefully this works. Nah, I let them go to attack. That was not smart of me. I mean, the Clarion's not going to make much of a difference. I mean, the Mira attack isn't going to make much of a difference because of the Clarion, but we'll see what they want to do here. We're going to go ahead and kill the Amira. I don't know if there's any flash convoke things going on. I guess he could have March to the Multitudes, which would be a great spot for him to play this. If he just plays March, we are doing very well because of this Clarion. And it looks like that's what he's about to do. Looks like he's about to march the board. Which makes sense why he didn't attack. Alright. Yeah, he's going to march for 4. Alright, and this is just very good for us. We're going to Deafening Clarion, choosing both modes. We're going to attack Vivian away. Yeah, we're actually going to finish off this Tristani. We're just going to make her fight herself. I know drawing cards is definitely enticing here, but I think I actually should have probably done that before the attack, gain another life. Alright, and that's the game. So, I definitely feel like I want negate here. Excuse me. Disdainful Stroke doesn't seem bad. They definitely have a lot of more than 4 drops that they play very early. So that almost incentivizes me to take out the Essence Scatters. Out of Sabotage and an Insight. Possibly I just leave in the Drakes. Maybe bring in a Niv. Because I just feel like once we get into the grindy late game, I just need to stay on top of as much of the mana as I can. I think I take out the Revitalize. Let me see what my CMC is here. Got a lot of the early threats, either with Justice Strike, Clarion, counter the majority of his things, Sabotage. We'll see how this does. I don't mind Teferi here because he can get rid of things like his Planeswalker package and Vivian. He may also have some of Johnny's that he might have in the side. I don't feel like he'd run those main, but maybe in the longer matchups, like Control. Alright. This is kind of a slow start. We'll see if our opponent keeps. If our opponent mulligans, this might be an enticing keep. Because they'll be down a card, we'll be drawing an extra card. And we do have this Cleansing Nova, so if they don't destroy us by turn 5 and we hit 2 more white sources. Alright, our opponent's mulliganing. I'm going to keep this. I'm going to try it out. It's not the best hand, it's not the fastest hand, but our opponent does not have discard spells. And we definitely have the ability to be very fast. Alright, we're going to start with this Sacred Foundry. That was a great draw there. Found a white source. Alright, our opponent did not play anything, which is a little surprising to me. Maybe their hand's a little slow, maybe it's a couple marches. Alright, they didn't play anything again. We're going to throw out this Crackling Drake there next turn. I'm very surprised our opponent didn't have a play until turn four. Yeah, there's that Ajani I was talking about possibly in the side. Alright, Ajani comes down and alts pretty fast. One blue, one red. We're gonna try and get there with this Crackling Drake. We're gonna try and slow that down. They might just have Alright, they're playing Vanguard. So it almost looks like they went from a green-white package to more of the mono-white aggro. I could be wrong, but the Vanguards kind of tell me different. Alright, I think we're going to... Chemist's Insight here. The other thing we can do too. Alright, we're gonna play out this land. We have to discard. We'll probably discard an Insight. The other thing we can do next turn is just tuck this Tyrant. I'm not gonna block this when it attacks. They'll just pay four and kill our thing. Alright, let's discard an Insight. Drawing all three Insights was kind of difficult. I think I sided one out. Yeah, I did. So. If he Vivians us here, especially, we're just gonna play a Teferi and tuck a Johnny. I know it's a short-term answer, but... If he doesn't have Vivian, that's kind of great for us, because we have to untap with a Crackling Drake. He does have Vivian here. He's going to probably take out that Crackling Drake. Yeah. So, what's the play here? I think it's still just play Teferi. Tick down on Ajani. Because if our opponent's not thinking about it and he... This creature land. Yeah, I'm gonna put this third from top, because if he pluses Vivian here, then it just bypasses the Johnny. I know he's gonna take out this Teferi, but we have a second one. Which again, this will get taken out by Teferi, but I think, yeah, okay. So our opponent just bypassed that. Oof, Carnage Tyrant. We have a Cleansing Nova. It doesn't take care of this Vanguard, but... Alright, he's going to play out Carnage Tyrant here. Oh, he's going to play out Tristani. Carnage Tyrant 7. No, it is 6. Surprised he didn't just slam that here. Alright, we're not in a great spot here, obviously. So he swings for 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. He has a Carnage Tyrant. If we draw white source, we have two Deafening Clarions. I'm debating ticking down this Teferi, taking out the Vivian. And then if he runs this Carnage Tyrant out, because 6, 7, 6, we draw white source. The only other play I can think of is play out this Drake. He probably minuses. He possibly minuses. I can't say he will. We block if he doesn't. Maybe it's better to play out this Drake than the throughout this Teferi, just the die. Because... I think a Johnny up to two target creatures. So 6, 7, 13. And then if our white source is a Sacred Foundry, we can't pay the 2. Sorry. Yeah, I am taking a long time to think about this. I think I'm gonna... Maybe the Drake's better, because if he doesn't kill it... We'll see what we draw here. I feel like he almost has to kill it with Vivian. If he kills it with Vivian, if we draw a white source here, that'd be great. We don't. Pay for life, indestructible. We can pay two to kill something. That doesn't feel great. Yeah, I guess. Maybe we fake something. And we just Justice Drake down a soldier. It's not the greatest play. He still gains the 2 life. It's minus a creature, though. Alright, locks it on. So... curious if he plays Carnage Tyrant and then just throws this Loxodon out with everything. I don't feel like he'd do that, but he might. If we double Clarion though next turn, it doesn't kill that Vanguard. Oof, that's rough. So, maybe it was better to take out that Vivian. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and try to take down a soldier here. Again, it does not do what we want it to do. But Niv-Mizzet, that does not help us here. How do we survive? Teferi, tick down, take out Vanguard. That's very rough on us. Alright, that's what we have to do to survive. Hopefully he attacks our Teferi, but he probably will just with Tristani. He won't do it with the soldier as well. I don't feel like he will, at least. Alright, we're just gonna pass through this turn. I don't have any plays. We're definitely kind of cornered. Alright, he played another Vanguard. Or he grabbed the Vanguard off the top of his library. So I'm down the 2. This man has not been treating us properly most of the evening. Carnage Tyrant. assuming. And Vanguard. Yep. Vanguard will indeed kill us, no matter what we draw. Yeah, there's just no out for us here. Just pay the four. Yeah, that was not good for us. Alright, down two games. Let's see if we can... Oh, was that only game one for us? No, that was game two. We won game one. Right? Right, I beat him with Crackling Drakes. I think. Do we want anything here? See, the Flyers just feel really rough against Vivian. Kind of sucks Ral can't hit other planeswalkers as well. Only answers for Carnage Tyrant are Cleansing Nova, which is kind of rough. Alright, we're going to go ahead and run this back. I don't know if it's proper. We're on the play, though. Hopefully we have a better draw. Alright, that's kind of another heavy hand. We're going to keep it, though. We have the Clarion. We have our mana sources. Alright, we're going to lead on a Sacred Foundry and pass the turn. Temple, pass. Alright, we'll play out this Glacial, pass the turn. Expansion Explosion's not bad. I'll see what he plays here, if anything. Another Teferi is not good for us. I probably should have played out the island to represent counter magic. This game is not well done by me. Alright, I'll let this resolve. See what he plays next turn. And there's the negate. That would have been nice. I'll run out this Clarion. Hopefully he plays something else this turn. Something nice. Maybe just as another history. I'll negate the second history. Kill the knights. No value. Or he'll run out a Loxodon. I'm assuming. Yep. I'm going to still run out this Clarion just so he does not get the Loxodon's not a knight, so it doesn't get boosted. Yep, Tristani. Not a good position for us, once again. Play Teferi here. Is there any incentive in ticking up? Or is it better just to tick down? And if I tick down, what do I hit? Tristani or Vanguard? Or should I just draw a card and make him swing these at it? I get hit for five. He might just go after me, actually. I guess I'll take out five damage for now. mean, he has a full grip right now. We're not in a good spot by any means. He could have another Carnage Tyrant as well. Not drawing these Cleansing Novas has really hurt us. I might actually move into a Settle the Wreckage main board. Or somewhere in the 75. Jeskai controls, I feel like a 50-50 matchup at the moment. 50-50 deck-wise. Yeah, and there's the Carnage Tyrant. Cleansing Nova off the top here would be nice, but of course we do not hit it. Ugh. I have to get rid of this Tristani just to survive. We are not doing hot here, people. Not in this game. I get hit down to 3 next turn. He has a Loxodon on top, and under that he has a Tristani. And I need Cleansing Nova off the top here, or I'm dead. Alright. Drake does not do it, unfortunately. Alright, good games. Alright, now we can try for that 3-2 like I was talking about earlier. Not sure how that is going to go for us, but we'll see. Alright, we'll go ahead and join. Yes, we'd like to play first. We are going to mulligan this hand. Something. It's not great. We'll put it on top. We're going to turn to Glacial Fortress. It'd just be like drawing, but we'd... Alright. This is possibly Jeskai control. Could be token. Not tokens, but weenie. No, it looks like Jeskai control. Alright. Hopefully we hit our land, and we don't. That is rough. Yep. Alright, this is probably the Phoenix version. Land. Alright, we hit a land. Enter's tapped, but it's better than nothing. Discard Phoenix. Radical idea. Alright, not jump started. So they're drawn. Drawing. It's probably also the version that runs, is it Staticaster? At the beginning of your upkeep, exile the top card of your library. If it's a non-land card, you may cast it this turn. Huh. That's a neat, enticive change to the deck. It basically puts a Wizard's Lightning. Oof. This is rough on us. At least now we can start countering things, but it's just... What are they exiling? Alright, they don't have a target for this Beacon Bolt. As of right now. Alright, there's a retreat. Enter's tapped. If they, insight here... No, they don't. Okay. I was hoping they'd, Chemister's Insight, and then, I'd get to expansion it, which would be nice for us in the position we're in. All right, Glacial Fortress. They play Glacial Fortress, but not from Exile Zone. Right? They can't. You may... If it's a non-land card, you may cast it. And they are just way ahead on mana right now. I'm going to opt to not, just because I don't really have much. I guess I could have expansioned it. Maybe I should have. Alright, here's the jump start. Alright, it looks like they're going to flip this. At the beginning of your upkeep, no, whenever you cast this, just your third spell in a turn. Okay, so it does not matter what that spell is. Alright, they're going to cast another Radical Idea, I'm assuming. Yep. And then they're going to get this Vanguard flipped, or Vance. Vance's Blasting Cannon. Alright, and there it is. They transform it, turn it into a Bolt, which is definitely rough on us. I should have tried to play this Teferi and get that. I just did not see that happening. Which is rough, because that takes down our Teferi almost immediately. Alright, I'll run out this Teferi. We're just in a rough spot, guys. That's not the ideal way to be playing. Alright. Yeah, this just isn't great. He's going to go ahead and bolt this. Any target, right? Any target. What is he? Oh, expansion. Alright. That seemed like a waste, but I won't judge. Oof. And we have to discard. Alright, I'm going to get rid of one of these sabotages. We just cannot draw lands for the life of us. Our opponent has 10 lands in hand. It's just not good. Alright. Yep, we can't do anything about that. We are in a rough shape. Right here's my opponent's graveyard, in case you're wondering where that went. I'm gonna try and draw some cards here. Alright. We got somewhere. Clarion, I guess. We are very behind on mana. We are very behind on cards. Look at this. We both have 5 cards in the graveyard. My opponent has 5 cards in exile. My opponent has all the lands. And 7 cards in his hand, and 32 cards in his deck, and we only have looked at 10 less than that. Alright, they're just playing this to get a counter. I wonder if our opponent's heavy removal, and if that's the case... So my opponent, I think, wants to draw a card here. They're definitely like a blue-red burn deck. Kinda just want to play this untapped. Let's see, 1, 2. I don't think I'm going to cast expansion this turn. So it may not be incisive. Alright, he's gonna bolt us. Yeah, my opponent can just sit here and, you know, cast spells and draw cards and bolt us to death. It's definitely a unique take on a lot of the decks I've seen standard at the moment. All right, we're gonna try and draw two cards. All right, it worked. Kind of want to run out this Cleansing Nova. Just get rid of that. And the question is, will it? It won't take care of the land, but. The other thing I do is just run this Teferi out and get rid of that, but. The awkward part about running Teferi out is it just immediately dies, but I have to get some value out of it at some point. We're just gonna run it out here. We'll plus it. Teferi basically gains us 6 life in a couple turns to try and figure out something. But overall, we're definitely not in a good spot. They could just have Banefire as well. Banefire would not be good for us. Alright, what do they have here? Alright, they're just casting cards at this point. Their deck definitely looks decent. I guess get rid of this island. Probably gonna, what is this? Spitfire the Teferi. Yep. They're heavy removal. This is actually a kind of a nice deck from the looks of it. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and draw some more cards here. We're going to discard this Justice Strike. Alright, and move on. Should I have like one main copy of I don't think we're going to run Cleansing Nova out here just yet. Maybe I do, just so they can't draw a bunch of extra cards. There's incentive to wait. I think I'm just gonna wait. Turn off. Alright, they have Radical Idea. They're gonna draw a card, and then they're gonna flash it back, and then they're gonna draw a card, and then they're gonna draw a card. So, our opponent has all the cards. And we have all the discards. So I don't think our opponent's running creatures. I'm gonna assume they're not. I'm gonna get rid of that. Next is the Syncopate. It's pretty bad when we're sitting here like, oh, what do I discard next? One, two, three, four, five. Nope, not yet. Alright, we're getting bolted for 3. Almost conceded there. Alright, they are inciting. Can we mill our opponent? We can force them to draw X cards with expansion. I kind of just want to... Oh my god, if we win this way, this is going to be an impressive win. I think we found her out. Alright, go ahead and draw cards, opponent. Because our opponent is heavy, heavy removal. Yep. So let's see. Next turn, they're going to bolt us, I'm assuming. Whenever cast your third spell on a turn. So we're going to counter this one. I should have... Might have misplayed that one a little bit. I'm curious if they have Banefire, though, because we could just lose here the Banefire, but let's see. Four. Let's call them four. Three. Six. We can make them draw six cards. Seven cards. Alright, so I think that's our out. Alright, we're going to go ahead and destroy all artifacts and enchantments. Alright, we do not want them killing us with these. So we're definitely going to try and destroy those. This will definitely, hopefully, slow them down some. And we have enough for two counter spells and then untap if they draw a bunch. What are they doing? Syncopate for a bunch. Explosion for two. We're going to leave a Glacial Fortress up. Graveyard this. Maybe we wanted them to draw those cards. Alright, they're drawing another card. Maybe I should have let them explode. Because I just kind of set our win condition, or our only win right now is kind of, because we're on a 5-turn clock. Alright, so we can make them draw 8. They need to draw like 10 cards. Ugh, that's rough. Alright, they're going to deal 3 to us. We have to find something. Alright, we have 4 turns left. We have another explosion. Maybe at the end of their turn we explosion them? Would that make any sense on doing? Alright, so they hit us down to 6. What if I just make them draw? Or can we just burn them out? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Down to 10. Nine, 10. Do we want to draw and attempt to burn them out, or make them draw and then discard a bunch of stuff? Maybe we do this because we have a couple ways of gaining life here. We're gonna attempt to do something here. I don't even know if they're running counter magic main board. I haven't seen a single thing yet. I'm assuming they are, but they just have expansion in response and it's going to kill us. I'm assuming that's what this is. For 12. Yeah, we don't have the mana. Alright, fair enough. Good game. Ah, they just made us draw. That's funny. Alright, Kind of want Niv here. Rouse Eric might be okay. Negates are coming in. Just stand full strokes. Lyra's probably not bad. Essence Scatters are coming out. Exelon's Binding can come in. Destroy target artifact or enchantment. Justice Strike. Clarions. Alright. Sort of converted mana cost. Hopefully they don't just, like, have stuff to deal with our stuff. Maybe we can come back. That explosion in response to the explosion was pretty incisive. Would you like to play first? Yes. Mulligan this. Mulligan that. Oh, not like this. Alright, keep. Alright. I don't really have much of a choice, I feel. I need to find a blue source. I don't even care if it enters tapped. I just need to find a blue source. Alright, this will give us some advantage. Not much, but some. Alright. Do we want it? We'll say no. We'll put this in tapped. We're really hoping to find a blue source next turn. There's our blue source. Here's our Drake. They didn't really see anything from us game one. So I don't know if they took out a lot of their control cards. Radical idea. Alright. We got something going. It's not really much. We have an OO Crackling Drake. Take it out. No, we don't want to put that in our graveyard. I want to draw that. Alright, we're going to play Teferi here. We're just going to take him up. Alright, now we have Negate. This is looking okay for us. Yep, there's a Drake. Oh, I really just want to run out this Niv-Mizzet next turn, if possible. Get some value going. Please. No. Alright, here comes Niv. Blue, blue, blue. Red, red, red. And we have this Negate backup, which is fantastic for us. Alright, we're just going to deal one here. Alright, blue. There we go. Alright, I think we're very much ahead in this game. But that could turn at any moment. Alright, that's fine. Can't really swing with any of their drakes. Their drakes will definitely die. Alright, what do I want? Yeah, we don't really need another land. We'll just throw this up top. Just draw another. Pretty soon we're gonna ultimate Teferi, so if he can't do anything really, then we're definitely ahead. I mean, he can start pinging Teferi for one, or yeah, I just didn't have anything to do with my mana here. So we have blue, blue, red. So we can sabotage and negate. Alright, we're going to sabotage this and draw a card. I'm sure it's very hard for him to justify fighting back. Alright, we're going to go ahead and negate that. So we're going to draw three cards here, which is just fantastic. On top. Alright, we found a removal spell. Alright, they're not swinging at Teferi, which, I mean, they can't really. I'm gonna say no to this. And there's just so much value in these. I need to make sure I untap that island. Alright, I'll just grab a Drake here. Island, clifftop. They're gonna gain some life here. I'm gonna draw. I do have two counter spells this turn, so might as well ionize here. Curious if they have another. I guess we'll see here. Alright, they conceded. Yeah, we had the Teferi ultimate next turn if he didn't swing. Alright, he's bringing in. So we're bringing the lava coils. He has the drakes in now. I feel like he took out some of his We're gonna play it like this. We have all the mana. We will keep this. We're on the draw. We're up two cards already. Three cards because of the draw. Did he bottom? Bottomed. It's not looking good for him. Or her. Alright, that'll give him something. Alright, I'm not gonna even fake a negate or anything. He does have enough spells, and he not missing mana. All right, there's a Drake. All right, so we do have Disdainful Stroke in case he can't play another Drake if he has one. All right, draw Sulfur Falls. I'm gonna pass the turn. Alright, we're actually going to Disdainful Stroke this because I want him low on cards. I do not want him to get any footing on this board. He has one card in hand, he's drawing a card off the top. He can Chemister's Insight next turn, but we're going to Teferi and tick down on this Drake. Or maybe we just Teferi tick up. He's probably going to discard something. You have a draw spell. Yeah, Ionize. Okay. That's fine with me. Alright, we're going to play as Clifftop, and we're going to pass the turn. We're going to Insight end of his turn. He's going to draw off this, I'm assuming. We want to keep up a... Okay, he's just loading this up so he can possibly deal 5 damage to us. What do you discard here? Discard a Glacial Fortress. He's not valuing his mana very much. Which, Drake is only in graveyard. Yeah, so it's not like... We're going to go ahead. And draw 2. See if he takes the bite. Okay, he's actually going to copy it and draw 2 himself. Deal 5 damage to any target. I wonder if I tick down on this Drake if he goes after. Yeah, syncope for 1 doesn't do anything. So now I'm tempted to I'm gonna tick down on the fire. All right, this is great. All right, so here's what I'm gonna do, blue. And that just brought us back in this game. He has more cards now. But I'm just going to tick down on this, not get blasted by that. I'm going to take out that. All right. And now we have a Teferi on 1, which isn't great. But as long as he doesn't have a burn spell for it, we're okay. All right. He has another Drake here, which is all right. Hopefully he plays another Drake, maybe. Alright, this is just great for us. We're going to Cleansing Nova. We're going to tick up Teferi. Alright. Destroy all creatures. Alright. And... yeah, we want to have 2 counter spells up. Alright, there we go. We're back in this. He used both those explosions on some draw spells. I'm gonna negate this. Yeah, he doesn't have any jumpstart cards left. Yeah, now we're just... we're just ahead by so much. Yes. And we drew Ralzeric. Yeah, I don't see our opponent coming back from this, but we'll see. I might have gotten a little greedy by that negate, but I'm hoping I didn't. Sure. All right. I think we're okay here. So, white, red, blue, row. Alright, we're gonna put that in our hand. Attack here. Hopefully it doesn't have a seal away. Alright, we're gonna untap here. Alright, and we're back. We're good. Of something uncounterable. I guess Nymphmizzet's uncounterable. Okay. And we're good. Alright, we're 2-2. Yes, I'd like to be on the play. No, I'd not like to keep this hand. This is rough moto. Come on now. We're keeping this. We're putting that on bottom. We are not doing very well to start. Down the five already. Not even a very good hand. Alright. We have a negate. Our opponent started on planes. They have Clifftop Retreat. Possibly White Weenie. Yep, Burrow's aggro, it looks like. Alright, we're doing it. We got some lands, and we have some counter magic. It's fine. I'm just gonna Clarion next turn. Yeah. See what their follow-up play is. If it's a Lyra. Aurelia, sorry. Nope. That is definitely a good thing for us. I'm curious why they're running Chromatic Lantern, but the fact that they are, the fact that they just played it, definitely a good thing for us in the spot we're in. Alright. Hopefully they don't just run out of Carnage Tyrant here or something. That would be definitely insane. Alright, Goblin Chain Whirler. I'm gonna go ahead and negate this one. I'm sorry, Essence Scatter it. I don't know if it's worth it or not, but if they don't have a follow-up, this is just okay for us. And their follow-up is a Lightning Strike. Okay, we'll take three. They probably have a... And Shock. Okay, they probably have an Experimental Frenzy as last card. But we have a negate for that. We're actually looking not in bad shape here. And Experimental Frenzy. No. Dragon Skull Summit. Alright, so our opponent is playing something. Some Mardu list, I'm assuming. Alright, we're gonna pause just for a moment. are back. Our opponent is lightning striking us. Our opponent is just whittling down our life total here. I'm very hesitant to tap out. I really wish we could get to our fifth land to play out this Teferi, and then we have at least negate back up. Our opponent really wants us to tap out, because I feel like the last card in their hand is Experimental Frenzy. And they're just, they just want to play it. Frenzy. No, Aurelia. Yeah, we're definitely going to counter that one. And we're going to put that on top, because we finally found a land. Alright. It's not a land to run out this Crackling Drake, but it's good enough for the moment. Alright. Our opponent has lands, I'm pretty sure. Alright, fifth land, Teferi. Yeah, there we go. Alright, hopefully we don't just die to something silly. That 2 points of damage might matter, but at this point, I'm just desperate for card advantage. Alright, we're going to run out this Drake next turn as well, now that we have our Teferi clock. If he has anything non-creature, we're okay. If he has a creature, I think we just Cleansing Nova it, or run out the Drake to block. Alright, he has an Aurelia. That's alright. So really, it does not give haste, which is a good thing. And, okay, we're gonna negate this for no reason. Other than pure satisfaction. Alright, gives Trample and Mentor and Vigilance. Doesn't give Mentor, has Mentor. Not a lot of people could remember that. Question is, do I Cleansing Nova here? Let's draw. Where's my play? Just Crackling Drake. Because is he going to run the Crackling Drake? I'm just going to Cleansing Nova here. Destroy all creatures. Play a land. Untap two. Here and here. Then I have Ionize for whatever he draws off the top. Yeah, we're definitely good here. We stabilized. Anything he plays, he's just going to get countered. Red, blue. Alright, there we go. A lot of people are running Detection Tower now because of Carnage Tyrant. Definitely debating throwing one in this list. Or a Jeskai, a blue-red, some sort of thing. Alright, our opponent conceded. We won game one. Definitely a aggressive deck. We probably want Ral, just to act as another removal spell. Possibly the Lava Coils. I could see not running the Lava Coils for Aurelia. I could see running the Seal Ways instead. Justice Strikes do not do, and Revitalize doesn't do what we want it to do. I'm curious if I bring in a Niv here. I probably want to get rid of a Teferi or two, maybe bring in a Lyra to fight Aurelia. Ixalan's Binding? I could see bringing that in. Disdainful Stroke, maybe. He has Aurelia, he might have the make two guys, +2/+2 the board. Or +1/+1 the board. For the most part, though, I feel like he's low to the ground, so maybe that isn't what we're looking for here. Maybe instead of Essence Scatter, I'm going to keep the Essence Scatter. I'm going to get rid of a Sabotage. Is this what we should be looking at? I have 6 win conditions. I feel like Niv is good, but I don't feel like I want 2 of them. I mean, Niv's good no matter what, but I feel like if this deck's running some Angels, some Flyers. Alright, we have Seal Away, we have Expansion Explosion, we have Syncopate. I'm going to keep this hand. I'm going to start with Steam Vents tapped. I'm going to hope all our opponent's lands enter tapped. We have a good hand to start. Alright, there we go. Oh, he's got something. Yep. Deal 1 damage. Each opponent discards a card. And puts the top card of their library into the graveyard. So I think the least... We're going to discard Expansion Explosion here. What do we lose? Sinister Sabotage. There's a lot of S's in this deck. Tongue ties me a lot. So he doesn't play anything, probably has double white cards in hand. And there's Niv. Alright, so we definitely have some powerful threats when we get up to 5 and 6 mana. It's just a matter of getting to 5 and 6 mana. Alright, play something good. Or play nothing. Alright, Crocodile, draw a land. Not quite a land. Alright, we'll pass the turn. Our opponent will play something, I hope, that we are going to sabotage. Johnny. Yeah, we're gonna sabotage that. We're gonna put a land on top. We're going to put that in graveyard. We really want to land here. We do not get a land. We are definitely in the territory of if he plays a non-creature spell and has 2 mana up, we are in a rough spot. Yep, and there's another. We're going to discard this Chemister's Insight. I want Lyra around. If we need to discard later, we can. But we'll see her. See here. We're kind of getting out of Syncopate range. Alright, he's main phasing this Lightning Bolt. I'm not sure why he's doing that. He's been doing it most of the game. He has 3 cards in hand. And another one. Alright, we're definitely getting mana flooded. I mean, mana. Not flooded. Whatever's opposite of that. There's definitely a drought in our island department. But not our opponents. And I am sad. Alright, we're going to go ahead and discard this Syncopate, because I don't really think it's doing much here. Please draw something. Ugh, not that. We're gonna get rid of one of these lava coils. Especially if our opponent has Aurelia. Actually, Aurelia doesn't get hit with either of these. This is rough. Alright, we finally hit a land. Now what do I do here? Alright, I guess I just pass the turn, because now I can cast these Chemister's Insights from my graveyard. And that's card advantage. Our opponent just keeps playing these lands, and I don't know what they haven't planned. Alright, we're going to go ahead, and we're going to Essence Scatter that. Alright, our opponent passes the turn. I think he's going to play things just so he gets cards out of our hands. Do I just run a Lyra out here? He has two cards in hand. I'm going to run this Lyra out. If he gets rid of it, that's fine. That was probably one of the worst ways to get rid of it. Yep. Now we're going to discard a card next turn. Alright, Goblin Chain Whirler. One card in hand. He's probably going to take our Lyra with that. Kinda. Alright, now. So I have an option of Lava Coiling. Niv just gives so much card value, it's hard not to just run him out here. We're going to have to discard a card. I'm going to just discard this Essence Scatter. Because we want... What's he have here? Ugh, Johnny. Probably plus, maybe minus. Yeah, he pluses. Which, that's fine. We have Lava Coil. Question is, does he have... We're just going to take the four. We're not in a bad spot here. Like, by any means. We're going to hit him. We're going to move to attacks, kill a Johnny. That's fine. We're going to hit him. Alright, in that case, we're in great shape. Okay, let's go attack a Johnny, kill a Johnny. Because we're going to Lava Coil here. I don't have any incentive to play out this Teferi yet. If I draw a land here, I might play out this Teferi. Okay, I drew a land, so I can play out this Teferi, keep up Seal Away. For any haste threats. Alright, white, blue, blue. Actually, I just took up Teferi. Deal one to him. Yep, there we go. Alright, we're looking in great shape here. So he's going to probably take our Lyra, I'm assuming. I don't think he has a ton of great... Yeah, he's going to just take our Lyra here. Which we can actually just tuck the Lyra back under our belt here. Which we might actually do. Yeah, we're going to do that. He doesn't have anything here. We're going to just do that. We're going to put that back in our library. We're going to play land here. We're going to draw a card. Alright, I think we're in good shape. I think we're winning this game. We're doing very well right now. I'd be very surprised if our opponent keeps playing more than a turn or two. I mean, he's dead on board next turn. We're swinging for 5 this turn. We'll bring him down to 10 after this trigger resolves. I don't want to tell him good games yet. Maybe he has a Cleansing Nova or something off the top that I'm not respecting. Alright, fair enough. discard. I'm gonna discard Cleansing Nova. Yeah, and our opponent's just dead here. I'm gonna go through the motions anyhow.